Hello everyone, welcome to day 27 of our 30 days of watercolor flowers. Today we are painting honeysuckle. Honeysuckles are such a beautiful flower. They are everywhere where I am from in Arizona, and I like to think of the top of the honeysuckle kind of like bunny ears coming out the top. Two arms on each side, a beard coming out the bottom, and then a tail at the end for the attachment to the greenery. We're going to keep the center open for the very large stamen that comes sticking out of the honeysuckle. And then we're also going to paint them sideways. So the bunny ears half hidden, the two arms that are coming out, and the beard all kind of squished together in more long and narrow shapes will make it look like they are coming from the side. And then we're also going to be painting some buds that are in these really long curved teardrop shapes, kind of upside down teardrop shapes. And then for the foliage, the leaves are very fluffy and small and bunched together. They're very close to the flower petals as well. Honeysuckles are found on a bush type plant, so they are bunched in this way all over the bush. Okay, we're going to start by picking up our bright cat orange. Honeysuckles are a beautiful bright orange, so I'm mixing it with our orangey yellow color we had down here on the bottom of our palette, and I'm also going to put in a little bit of cad red to get a deepness in the color. We want this first layer we put down to be the lightest layer, so we are adding water to make it a little bit of a light wash. Honeysuckles are a trumpet type flower, so saying the bunny ears, the arms, the beard, and then the tail for the attachment, which is that trumpet that is coming down to attach to the greenery, that just really helps me visualize how I can put shapes down to get the shape that I want that looks like a honeysuckle. Once I've got the initial colors down, I've left the center open and I have a little bit of white space between the petals to give some distinction. I put a higher concentration of cad red right at the spot where the attachment is meeting those petals, that trumpet attachment. That just gives a little bit of shadow while everything is still wet. Now for these honeysuckle that we're seeing from the side, I can take those shapes that I know to make, the bunny ears, the arm, the beard, and the tail. I can take half of that shape and paint it a little bit longer, and it will give the illusion that we are looking at a honeysuckle flower from the side. And then a few simple curved long strokes, almost like a leaf, to create the buds for the honeysuckle. And then just change the width and the size for, the baby buds versus the ones that are about to bloom. Now we're going to add some cad red to our mixture already on our palette, and we are going to continue to amp up the shadowy color. So I'm putting this color around the edge of the beard. I'm putting it where the beard and the bunny ears are meeting, where the trumpet is meeting the other flower petals, and at the tips of the baby buds. I'm doing this while everything is still wet, so we get a nice gradual bleed from that light orange color to a darker red color. Now we are going to pick up some bright alizarin crimson in a high concentration on the tip of our brush. This is for the very long stamen that is coming out of the middle of the honeysuckle. So to paint this, I'm using very light pressure with the tip of my brush and just drawing that out into a slight curve and then doing a little dot at the end. Honeysuckle have other stamen that come out, but this is the only one that is bright pink. Okay, while we let all of that dry, we are going to pick up some sap green and start working on the greenery. I'm mixing the sap green with green that is already on my palette, but I'm going to start by doing some little bits of greenery at the base of my buds and my flowers to create that attachment to the greenery. So they have a little attachment that comes just up onto the flower, and then we are going to start making our leaves. Again, these leaves are really fluffy and rounded, and I'm just using the side of my brush in some kind of wavy circular motions to get the texture. These are really abstract leaves. They don't have to be all connected, but we want them bunched together. And I do little groupings so that it looks really natural. I don't want everything just one big giant bunch, so I'll group some, and then I start grouping in a different direction, and then you can kind of taper them off kind of in a cone-like shape where you start to get smaller and more pointy as the leaves come down. But just always step back from your painting and see where you can kind of add things if you feel like there's an awkward gap. And then using very light pressure with the tip of my brush, I am bringing a line to kind of connect them a little bit so they're not just floating in space. I also want to add some leaves at the top so it feels like the leaves and the honeysuckle are fully encompassed. They're all together on this bush, but I don't want the leaves to get in the way of the yellow stamen I'm about to paint. So I'm not putting any up on the sides right next to where that's going to be. I'm picking up some dark yellow gamboge color to paint this center stamen. These are the stamen that are really full, bright yellow coming out the center around the pink center stamen, and they have black tips. So we're going to paint some really simple lines and let them completely dry so we can add black tips without it blending into the yellow watercolor. Now I'm adding some ultramarine blue to my sap green mixture on my palette, a little bit more sap green to make sure it stays green. And this is going to be our deep contrasting color we are adding to our leaves. Now I like to focus this color towards where the leaf is going to be attached to the stem. So just at the bottom mostly, and I use really light pressure, do a really quick stroke. It's just an idea of depth. We don't want it to look really flat. We want to find ways to have light tones, mid tones, and dark tones. So don't be afraid of this harsh line when you place it. My first instinct is to always smooth it out, but sometimes the harsh lines are good. We'll embrace them. Now we're picking up a higher concentration of orange, mixing it into the orange that we had on our palette, and then bringing that to create the contrasting color on our flowers. So just like we added the contrasting harsh lines to the leaves, we also want to dab in some of those colors on the flowers. A little bit goes a long way, and we're just trying to bump up where we've already been placing it, because like I was saying with the leaves, we have our lighter tones, which were the original colors we put down, the mid-tones that we kind of blended in, and then now we have our darker tones that we are leaving a really harsh line, so it adds a lot of depth and a really nice contrast. Now I'm picking up a very highly pigmented concentration of black. I want very little water on my brush. You can see I'm kind of dabbing it on my paper towel a lot because I want a very kind of dry brush to put this paint down because I want this mark to be very precise. So these are the tiny little dots at the end of the yellow stamen, and this really makes the whole piece pop. We want these so tiny, so short, almost like a tiny little rectangle. They're like a line more than a dot. And then I'm going to add just the tiniest bit of contrast to that bright pink center stamen by putting some alizarin crimson on my brush and just using the very tippy tip of my brush and the tiniest bit of pressure. And with that, our honeysuckles are finished. Now we get to add our honeysuckles to our watercolor flower guide in the day 27 spot. I love honeysuckles. I think they are such an underrated flower and they add such great texture and color. That bright orange is just my favorite. Thank you so much for being here today while we painted day 27, the honeysuckle. I will see you all tomorrow for day 28. Bye.